Hey team, what's going on? Well, today we're going to continue with our celebrity artist series. We've been taking a look at a bunch of different celebrities who felt that their fame and fortune needed to be accentuated with other types of art form than their what they're known for, what their celebrity comes from. You know, we're not talking about painters doing more painting. We're talking about people like, well, today's topic, Shia LaBeouf, who is also a performing artist. That's what we're doing today on Studio 214. Well, you know, my name is Gregory. And you know, all this is not to say that celebrities who become artists who are celebrities are something bad, you know, not at all. I mean, who could say that about Bob? I love you, Bob. But isn't he right, folks? I mean, come on. Anyway, so let's go ahead and dive into some more Shia LaBeouf art. LaBeouf. And this is a fun one. All my movies. So Shia sat down and he's watched all of his movies. Every one he's ever been in for 3 straight days. He was filmed and we have some outstanding memes and GIFs from it. GIFs and memes. Check this one out. When your Monday morning lecture feels like it's never going to end. Oh man, we've all been there. Oh, he's sleepy. And this one's fun. This is Shia and pizza. Guys gotta eat. Pizza. Way to go, Shia. Now I'm hungry. Let's see another one. When you're about to take a winning shot in a game of beer pong, but your partner doesn't think you can nail it. Yeah, I'll buy that. All right, so that's what he did. He did that for a bunch. There's a bunch of other ones. Go ahead and check out the links in the description for this, and you can check out all these. One more. When your crush likes your Instagram photo. More like when the person stalking you likes your Instagram photo. Yeah.
Nice photo, pap.
Yeah, that's just creepy. Anyway, Shia LaBeouf wears a paper bag on his head to the premiere of Nymphomaniac at the Berlin Film Festival following Eric Cantona. I don't know what that whole part, but here's the point. He went to a film premiere with this bag on his head that said, "I am not famous anymore." It's all part of his whole idea that his whole life is a performance art project. See right here. The actor who recently claimed his entire life was an art project took to the red carpet wearing some rather fetching headgear. So that's one of them. If you'd like to take a look at some of the other performance art pieces of Shia, go ahead and follow that card up there and take a look at part one. There's some interesting performance art pieces. And of course, the problem we have is not so much with performance art pieces or Shia LaBeouf himself.
Liar!
Except that performance art from celebrities, like people like Shia, tends to be all about the performer, not about the art. And if your art can't stand it on its own merits, then I don't really care about it. And if we're there to see art, let's see art. Let's have the art stand on its own. Not like, oh, hey, this is art that sucks, but someone famous made it, so it's awesome! And we have way too much of that already. Check these other videos for a discussion on those. I'm looking at you, James Franco. I'm looking at you, Jim Carrey. Not really. I think he's talented, but it's just weird, man. All right, so we have been taking a look at some of Shia LaBeouf's best performance art pieces. This article's in the tank. The guest contributor loves Shia because this is not an ironic piece. This is a celebratory, congratulatory piece. Anyway, we're talking about Shia awkwardly. Have you guys seen this one? Shia LaBeouf awkwardly frolics 12-year-old in giant bird cage. Guys, this is. Here we go. It's really weird. And see that. Now, Shia, that's a 12-year-old girl, and they're both in nude undergarments, and they're going to be dancing in a large birdcage aggressively. I mean, what the hell is going on here? There is a problem with pedophilia charges, as you can see. I mean, what the hell is going on? And the problem is that little girl was shy when he was 12. He was being used by the industry, by his parents who were getting a payday. And the same thing that happened to him that he's railing against in his new movie, Honeypot, is happening here. And you would think he would just be more self-aware of it. You just think he would, but he's not. I mean, what the f*** is going on here? This is some bullshit. But you should see the comments, man. People are like, oh, this is so beautiful. He's so brave and beautiful. This is not brave and beautiful. This is disgusting. And I don't know. I don't know why her parents even allowed this. And with his experience as a child actor, being being used, being exploited, you'd think he would just understand what's actually happening here. This isn't just some sweet, innocent dance cage fight. This is. I mean. Seen enough? I've seen enough. What do y'all think? Let me know in the comment. So those are the top. Those are all the fun, best performance art piece. Now, I'm not a big fan of performance art, mostly because the art sort of gets shelved, and it's all about the performer or the artist, not so much about the art form or whatever they're trying to communicate, you know, on, like we've talked about before. But now, the thing is let's take a second here to actually understand Shia just a little bit. He's in a new movie called Honey Boy, and he is the Honey Boy, and he plays his father, who's abusive, drug-dealing, drug-addicted, abusive father that Shia LaBeouf is playing, as he abuses himself through the, you know, being a boy actor, which, you know, again, feels like a vanity piece, but, you know, when you really delve into it, there's some interesting, real human elements to it, and I think it might be interesting, although I haven't seen it. I'm just talking about what they say here. I don't know if you know, Shia has been in the movie business for a very long time, and he had some very, very, very questionable decisions that his parents let him make. Oh my goodness. Like, for instance, he dressed as a clown to help his parents sell snow cones and hot dogs at age of 3. By 10, LaBeouf was performing really foul stand-up comedy in Pasadena, which led to a gig warming up the audience and later performing skits on The Tonight Show. Cool, cool. At 11, he met a child actor that only went to school for 3 hours a day. So he liked that, which, you know, honestly, who wouldn't? But the thing is, he got a manager who let the 11 and 12-year-old live with her. And I mean, you got to get a job somehow, but who allows this to happen? Parent, this is ridiculous. So anyway, Disney, he got a job on Even Steven as one of the actors, and Disney paid his father, the drug addicted abusive father, to come in and be his caretaker, because child labor laws say he's going to be on set all day. He's got to have a guardian there to make decisions for him, because these are big decisions with lots of money, and you have to have someone who can sign and be a guardian. Well, like I said, a guardian that's looking into the best interest of the child. However, this is oftentimes a gravy train for the parents, hence the term honey boy, because all that honey, all that money was coming off the boy and his hard work, and all the dad had to do is sit there and chill and not abuse his son, which apparently he did. And so you can understand that. Man, it really, it says here, his father was a rage-prone Vietnam vet, registered sex offender, and habitual ne'er-do-well who makes his son's life miserable, but also provokes in him the emotional response necessary to act well enough to earn the sort of praise LaBeouf coveted. Basically, things were so unstable, he just had these emotional swings, which, you know, if you can tap into that while acting in front of the camera, you can get an Emmy, which he got, a daytime Emmy for his work on Even Steven. You can tap into it, and you can really delve the depths of your soul.
And I pity for those whose end mirrors mine, and I pity myself. I'm helpless. Thank you.
Because that's what's happening in the trailer. Every time they say cut, you've got to go back to your terrible parent, who's your guardian, who's out, has a whole studio machine behind him, because if he's not there, LaBeouf's not there. So they had a huge investment to keep him going, which means it all the abuse became systemic.
I can't fucking embrace it!
So he had a rough childhood, and that's rough, man. My heart goes out to you, but it doesn't mean your art's any good. I mean, I'm a combat vet. I got a tragic backstory for days, and my art sucks. Whew, have you seen it? Woo! Especially the performance art. It's all about you, and I'm just, well, what can I say? I don't got time for that. Also, like this, he will not divide us. And then you also start thinking of yourself in stupid ways, like LaBeouf. That's what he's going by, LaBeouf. He will not divide us is an ongoing durational artwork by LaBeouf. So he's too good for a first name now. Cool. I mean, honestly, we all know who it is. We all know what LaBeouf. I just read it. How can you not get it straight? When you say my name, you get it right! Anyway, good times, huh? And this is why it's a hard switch from being a celebrity to being an artist, because an artist is about the art. It's not about the celebrity. Celebrity and who you are is secondary to your art. And that's obviously not what... You notice that all of Shia's performance art pieces have him center stage. It's all about him. They're all ego pieces. It's pretty ridiculous. And, you know, it's actually ruined me. I don't even want to see a movie with Shia anymore. What do y'all think? Let me know in the comments. Thank you so much for watching.
Come on.
James Franco.